One long-standing problem with Python's type annotation system is how to declare a type for something that hasn't been defined yet at that point in the code. There's a couple of interim solutions to this problem, some more effective than others, but Python 3.14, now in beta, applies the best possible solution and makes it a core part of the language. Let's see how this works in action. First, let's take a look at the problem I'm describing. We have here some code where I have a type annotation in a class method that refers to another class that hasn't been defined yet. If I try to run this code in 3.13 or lower, I immediately get an error. Now, a few solutions do exist for this. One is to refactor my code so that the object used for annotations is defined first. In simple cases like this, you can restructure without too much effort. But let's say all of this is part of some much larger, more complex program where we can't easily reorder our declarations. In that case, we have a few options. The first is to use what's called stringized annotations. All this involves is making the annotations into strings rather than references to objects. This way, the annotations can be evaluated without needing the object reference just then. But this doesn't work well for runtime use cases. And there's a whole growing field of projects like Pydantic that use Python type annotations at runtime. The next solution is to use the annotations import from the future module. What this does is change the behavior at the module level of how annotations are handled. Instead of being evaluated eagerly, that is, whenever they're first encountered in a top-to-bottom reading of the code, they're turned into a property of the object called annotations and evaluated lazily on demand. In this example, we can see the type annotations for the method frob by just looking at its annotations object. But again, the issue remains that we're seeing a string of the object name, not the object itself, not a reference to the object. To get the object takes more work. But with Python 3.14, all of this has been revamped and made much more useful. First of all, we no longer need to import annotations from future. The new behavior that we're going to see is part of the language natively going forward. And second, when we inspect the annotations, we see that we now have the actual object being referenced. Also, we get another nice bonus. The annotation is only evaluated when we inspect annotations the first time. So there is no performance cost imposed on adding annotations that work this way. Now, if you still need the old behavior, you can import annotations like this and get the stringified versions of the annotation data. But going forward, it's going to be more useful to have the actual object since you can always get the name from that. So if you're now trying out the Python 3.14 beta, you can experiment with this behavior and figure out a migration path away from using the future import for annotations, all for the sake of better type annotation in your Python code. And that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.